Hello and welcome to Sympathise Kids Church Online. Thank you for joining us. It's great to be together and it's Easter Sunday. What a wonderful day. I hope you're having a really good time and I hope you've got your tickets to join us later for the Easter Trail around the church, weather permitting. Hopefully it's going to remain sunny. So we have a really good lineup for you today. We have Ali Ryder, who is, yes, the wife of Ollie Ryder and mother to Hannah and Tabitha. She has a wonderful message for us today and we have an object lesson from me. So do stay tuned. I hope you can see that and see what Easter Sunday is about. So I look forward to sharing that with you and spending that time together. So today we celebrate the resurrection of Jesus. It's such a joyful day and a joyful time. And let us remember what today is all about as we worship and celebrate. So let's go into prayer before we have some worship time together. So Heavenly Father, thank you for your Son that you sent to earth to die on the cross so that we could be forgiven for our sins. Lord Jesus, we lift our sins to you now, Lord, and we ask for forgiveness for them, and we rejoice in your death and resurrection on the cross. Amen.
The empty cross. Jesus. He was a real person who lived on this earth 2,000 years ago. He was born in strange circumstances in Bethlehem. He grew up in Nazareth with his mother Mary and her husband Joseph. When Jesus was about 30 years old, he started teaching people about God. He said he'd come from God and did some amazing miracles to prove it. He made sick people better, fed thousands of people with only a little bit of food. He told a storm to stop, and it did. And he even raised some dead people back to life. Some people loved it, but Jesus worried the leaders. They didn't like what he was saying and doing, so they arrested him and sentenced him to death. The soldiers took Jesus to Golgotha, which means place of the skull. There, they gave him some wine mixed with a drug to ease the pain, but he refused to drink it. They nailed Jesus to a cross and gambled to see who would get his clothes. It was about 9 o'clock in the morning when they nailed him to the cross. On it was a sign that told why he was nailed there. It read, "This is the King of the Jews." The soldiers also nailed two criminals on crosses, one to the right of Jesus and the other to his left. People who passed by said terrible things about Jesus. They shook their heads and shouted, "Ha! So you're the one who claimed you could tear down the temple and build it again in 3 days. Save yourself and come down from the cross." The chief priests and the teachers of the law also made fun of Jesus. They said to each other, "He saved others, but he can't save himself. If he is the Messiah, the King of Israel, let him come down from the cross, then we will see and believe." The two criminals also said cruel things to Jesus. About noon, the sky turned dark and stayed that way until around 3 o'clock. Then, about that time, Jesus shouted, "Eloi, Eloi, lema sabachthani," which means, my God, why have you deserted me?" Some of the people standing there heard Jesus and said, "Is he calling for Elijah?" One of them ran and grabbed a sponge. After he had soaked it in wine, he put it on a stick and held it up to Jesus. He said, "Let's wait and see if Elijah will come and take him down." Jesus shouted and then died. At once, the curtain in the temple tore in two from top to bottom. A Roman army officer was standing in front of Jesus. When the officer saw how Jesus died, he said, "This man really was the Son of God." After the Sabbath, Mary Magdalene, Salome, and Mary, the mother of James, bought some spices to put on Jesus' body. Very early on Sunday morning, just as the sun was coming up, they went to the tomb. On the way, they were asking each other, "Who will roll the stone away from the entrance for us?" But when they looked, they saw that the stone had already been rolled away, and it was a huge stone. The women went into the tomb, and on the right side, they saw a young man in a white robe sitting there. They were alarmed. The man said, "Don't be alarmed. You are looking for Jesus from Nazareth, who was nailed to a cross. God has raised him to life, and he isn't here. You can see the place where they put his body. Now go and tell his disciples, especially Peter, that he will go ahead of you to Galilee. You will see him there, just as he told you."
Hey there, thanks for joining us on Easter Sunday. So my name's Julia, I'm the kids pastor here at St. Matthias Church Plymouth, and I've got a little Easter object lesson for you. So I wonder what Easter means to you. For some of us, it's really hard to understand, isn't it, what happened to Jesus on the cross and why he died and what that means to us. So hopefully this might make it a little bit easier for you to understand. So I want you to imagine, if you can, that you are this penny here, and you're just there in the world, and try as much as you can. It's really difficult to be good all of the time. We all do little bad things, and we call that sin. And we get eventually covered in sin.
so much that it surrounds us and it becomes all-encompassing over us. But then Jesus came. Imagine this is Jesus. I am the light of the world. So Jesus came to give us light and to restore us. Please stay a light candle. And then at Easter Sunday, Jesus died on the cross. Tense moment. And as Jesus died on the cross, all of our sins were forgiven and soaked up. So as you can see, they no longer surround us. And hopefully that makes it a little bit easy for you to understand that you can see now we are free from sin because of Jesus dying on the cross on Easter Sunday. What a wonderful day to celebrate that we are free from our sins. We're free from all of the bad things because of Jesus dying. He took all of our sins for us.
Hello, everybody. When you hear the word Easter, you might bring to mind Easter bunnies, maybe chocolate eggs. Maybe you're thinking of having an Easter egg hunt in the garden, or maybe you're thinking of putting on your best clothes and coming to church on Easter Day. But what is Easter really all about? That's what we're going to talk about today, to understand what Jesus did at Easter. But to do that, we have to go all the way back to the beginning of the Bible, when God created everything. So God made the world and everything in it. The first people, Adam and Eve, he put in the garden and gave them this beautiful garden to live in. The world was perfect. Adam and Eve had a good relationship with God. They talked to God all the time and spent time with him. And the garden was filled with gentle animals and great food to eat. But there was only one tree in the garden which God told Adam and Eve that they couldn't eat from. God had given the humans one rule, but could they keep it? No, they couldn't. They chose to eat from that tree. And in doing so, they separated themselves from God. The perfection that had been in the world was destroyed. And people had brought sin. We use that word sin to describe what's going on there. Sin took away the good relationship that God and Adam had had. God and Adam and Eve had had together, and created this great chasm between them. This great distance. For thousands of years, people have tried to cross that distance, but we can't do it. And that's the bad news. But here's the good news. We may not be able to cross that distance, but God can. And God did. God loves us so much. He wants us to have a good relationship with him, like he did with Adam and Eve at the beginning. He doesn't want our sin to separate us from him. So God sent the Father sent his son, Jesus, to earth. Jesus left heaven. He came to earth so that he could make a way for us to have that good relationship with God again. But how could he do that? Remember back in the garden, God had told Adam and Eve that eating of the tree would cause them to die. So sin brings death and separation from God. Jesus came to take our death for us. The word that we use for that is sacrifice. Jesus died on the cross as a sacrifice for our sins. I've borrowed Tabitha's Bible to quickly read from in John chapter 19, verse 30. So they put Jesus on the cross, and it says, after Jesus drank, he said, "It is finished." Then he bowed his head and he died. And moving on to verse 38. Later, Joseph asked Pilate for Jesus' body. Joseph was from the town of Arimathea. He was a follower of Jesus, but he followed Jesus secretly because he was afraid of the Jewish leaders. After Pilate gave him permission, Joseph came and took the body away. Nicodemus went with Joseph. He was the man who had earlier visited Jesus at night. Nicodemus brought some mixed spices that weighed about 75 pounds. The two men took Jesus' body. They wrapped it in strips of linen cloth along with the spices. That was the way that Jews buried people. When Jesus said, "It is finished," he didn't just mean that his life was finished. It meant that his work that he came to do was finished. He came to die for us, and he succeeded in his mission. After his death on the Friday, what we now call Good Friday, Jesus was taken down from the cross and placed in a tomb that belonged to Joseph of Arimathea. For everyone involved, they thought that this was the end of the story. But then, on Sunday, Mary Magdalene went to visit the tomb. It's like when you go and visit a cemetery. They go to the place where a loved one's body is buried. But when Mary got to the tomb, it was empty. There was nobody to visit. Mary didn't understand what had happened. So we're going to read again from John chapter 20, verse 11. Mary stood outside the tomb crying. As she cried, she bent over to look into the tomb. She saw two angels dressed in white. They were seated where Jesus' body had been. One of them was where Jesus' head had been laid. The other sat where his feet had been placed. They asked her, "Woman, why are you crying?" "They have taken my Lord away," she said, "and I don't know where they've put him." Then she turned around and saw Jesus standing there, but she didn't know it was Jesus. He asked her, "Woman, why are you crying? What are you looking for?" She thought he was the gardener. So she said, "Sir, did you carry him away? Tell me where you put him, then I will go and get him." Jesus said to her, "Mary." She turned towards him and then she cried out in the Aramaic language, "Rabboni." Rabboni means teacher. Jesus said, "Don't hold on to me yet. I've not yet ascended to the Father. Instead, go to those who believe in me. Tell them I'm ascending to my Father and your Father, to my God and your God." Mary Magdalene went to the disciples with the news. She said, "I have seen the Lord," and she told him that he had said these things to her. Jesus is alive. He conquered death. He destroyed sin. And in this picture here, he made a way through the cross for us to get back to God and have relationship with God again. If we put our trust in Jesus, he will give us new life with him. He takes away our sin and he will give us back that good relationship. Do you know Jesus today? Do you believe that he died for you and rose from the dead? Do you put your trust in him? If you answered yes, then remember that Easter is a time to celebrate what Jesus did for us. Actually, every time we come to church, we celebrate that. In fact, you can celebrate that all the time, wherever you are. The news is not too good to celebrate all the time and to share it with others. But if you haven't met Jesus yet, but you want to know him, today is your day. Pray to him. Ask him to come into your heart. Ask him to take away your sin. Ask him to give you a good relationship with God. God loves us and wants to have relationship with us. He sent Jesus to die for us to take away our sin. Jesus rose from the dead. This is good news. This is happiness. This is Easter. I'm going to close with a simple prayer. So if it helps you to concentrate, feel free to close your eyes. Dear God, thank you for sending Jesus to earth so that because of his death and resurrection, our sins can be forgiven and we can have a good relationship with you. Amen. Thanks, everybody. Have a great Easter.
Jesus is alive. One, two, three. Jesus is alive. He died for you and me. But on day three, Jesus rose again. Jesus is alive. One, two, three. Jesus is alive. One, two, three. Jesus is alive.
Thank you, Ali. Thank you, me, for the object lesson. Hopefully, that illustration really helps you to understand why Jesus dying on the cross does help us to forgive our sins, and what Jesus did for us was such a selfless thing, and what God did sending his son to die for us on the cross was such a selfless thing. That means that we can live with the confidence of knowing that when we do sin, when we do mess up, which we always do, that we don't have to let it oppress us. We don't have to let it get on top of us. We can just give it to God because Jesus came to be our light and our guide. So thank you for that. Hopefully many of you are coming today to our Easter trail. I look forward to seeing you soon, and if not, we will be continuing our church online. For those of you that can't join us in the building, Charlie, who has been with us on kids team for a very, very long time, part of our loved St. Matt's family, is still facilitating that, and we'd love to get as many of you involved as possible. So if you do hear from Charlie, then do respond and get involved and share with us your lovely prayers and what you've been getting up to over this third lockdown. So have a great Sunday, guys. See you later, if not, see you next week. Bye.
Fierce as droughts and storms.